Who are you?
Beer Drink Shorty here, and I came across a somewhat disturbing yet pretty interesting video on YouTube. It seems pretty genuine, but for what it is, whenever you come across things like this, you can't really take it 100% legit. However, the one thing that I will say, whenever it comes to the more success, taking it to the next level they talk about, which is taking it to another level, a higher power, a higher being, like pretty much is taking it to the another level. Conor McGregor, Robert Conor's pretty much blows the whistle. Oh, whoa. Is it in me? He blows the whistle on a government agenda to pretty much take control of urban black culture. Music through music. Just, I look into everything, but I don't take everything too literal, and I don't take everything to heart. However, I look at this side of it, I look on that side of it, I get my own outlook on it. But this right here is a very interesting video. Go ahead and check this out, and it's funny because it even follows up with a pretty convincing. Once again, who are you?
For those of you that can see this video or hear this audio, I just wanted to make you aware of what's going on. I feel if I disseminate this information, I may actually get a night's sleep. I'm showing my face, and I will reveal my name for my own protection. So if something were to happen to me, you know it was not an accident. My name is Robert Conors, and I have served with the Department of Defense for over 20 years. Prior to that, I served active duty campaigns in both Iran and Vietnam. I have served my country with honor and distinction. My record speaks for itself. As an ex-DOD operative, it was my duty to protect the Constitution and mitigate foreign and domestic threats in this country. I joined the department to create a safer world for my children and now grandchildren. Unfortunately, the last decade of my career, I have seen and been a part of one of the biggest threats to this great nation and its citizens. In March of 1994, I was brought in as Director of Communications for a project called Operation Sedgwick, formed under President Ronald Wilson Reagan in 1989. This program was the second stage in the project called MKUltra. Its focus and sole purpose was the control of the African American population and urban youth through music. Yes, you heard me correctly, through music. I have in my possession a series of video and audio recordings detailing the existence of this project. My division was ordered to destroy all documentation and archive footage. I, in good conscience, could not. This is the information that the American public, along with the families involved, were told bold-faced lies about. From the first-degree murder of Lassane Parrish Crooks, also known as Tupac Shakur, to the evidence of influence of entities well beyond this federal government, beyond this world, will be revealed in these tapes. To my friends still at the department, please, I repeat, please join me. For the Bible says, whoever knows the right thing to do is, but fails to do it, for him it is sin. I can no longer live in sin. So, I am giving the Department of Defense until Monday, September 23rd, to do the right thing and disclose this information. If they do not, I will release these tapes to the media outlets and into public domain via YouTube. And to show I'm not bluffing, I will release Michael Jackson's final phone call on the eve of his death. Mr. Jackson's phone was being tapped, and he is speaking of a government conspiracy to murder him. I know this video and this channel will probably be deleted, so I urge you, please save, download, and re-upload everything that I release for freedom of information's sake. God bless you.
But just read into to everything. Watch this video, read into everything, and get your own conclusion. Really, you can't have a conclusion. Get your own assessment of everything that you put together.
What do you mean? Talk to me.
I can't talk about it over the phone. I don't know it's going to happen, but I just feel in my soul, only God knows, they could shoot me. They could stab me. They could frame me and say I will reduce them on drugs.
Who could do these things?
It's not the government. It's more than the government. But I don't know how to do it. I don't care. They can take me. I don't even care my life anymore. I just want my children to be okay.
Michael.